Veuillez accueillir Behrang Sharif.
A classical piano has claviers that when we press them, they send these mechanical signals through wires to the hammers in the resonating box where they bounce on the strings and generate sound. The labeled line theory, a common model of how our sensory system works, likens our sensory machinery to a piano. With receptors on the skin, acting like tiny keys of a piano that sense stimuli and send their message through their specific nerves to the spinal cord, which is the resonating box of the sensory system where the messages are turned into perceptions. This simplified and clever way of looking at the somatosensory system has also taught us about disease conditions like chronic pain, where one of these sensations is out of tune. I hope that you appreciate that out-of-tune notes or misplaced notes, whether they are played with higher intensity than they should be, or if they are played at times that we don't expect them, or if they are played instead of other notes, they are going to make it hard to appreciate the music of sensation. Unfortunately, this might be what patients who are suffering from chronic pain are constantly dealing with. When they have hypersensitivity to pain, sounds with higher volume, when they have idiopathic pain, pain coming out of nowhere, or when they have allodynia, where other sensations like a gentle touch can turn into pain. This simplified version of the sensory system has also inspired scientists to do what I call compartmentalized therapy, which is basically focusing on the elements of the system that are involved in generating pain. In other words, if we break the key that is generating a note, or if we loosen the wire that is sending that message to the hammers, or if we dampen the strings in the resonating box, we could silence that loud noise and treat pain. But I also think that this overly simplified system and model might be the reason that we haven't been very successful in treating pain. In my study, we decided to look at pain among other sensations. In this case, itch, or how Max von Frey would call it, pain's little brother. Through some fancy genetic tools and techniques, we were able to put chemogenetic actuators on a subpopulation of neurons that were previously defined as itch-specific. In my mind, basically, I think like installing these volume knobs that can only be turned on upon injection of a chemical that is otherwise inert. When we did this and we injected that chemical, we, as expected, generated itch, and the animals were sensing itch. But we didn't stop there. We thought, how can we activate these same neurons in other ways? So we went on and we put optogenetic actuators that, in my mind, are like Morse keys installed on the same population of neurons. These Morse keys, though, can only be activated upon shining a blue laser. When we did that, the animals, to our surprise, showed pain and not itch. In the piano analogy, this means that there is a way to press the D key to get the E sound, or move the E hammer in the resonating box. I thought, there is something missing here, so we need to bring a new model. So first things first, we can play and recapitulate whatever we could in a piano model. We can play the same melodies. But what we have with a guitar is some versatility and flexibility that we don't have in a piano, meaning that by repositioning our second hand, we can generate different tunes, different notes from the same string, and we can modulate the sounds that are generated. This also gives the guitar a very unique capability compared to the piano, and that is compensation for missing parts. Even if there is a significant part of the components of a system missing, here two out of the four strings of a guitar, we can play the same tune. And I think this might be what is happening with some of these compartmentalized therapies that we fail at. We target one element of the system, the pain goes down. After a while, the system learns to compensate for those missing parts and modulates the remaining parts to generate the same sound. I'm going to leave this pain talk by saying a reminder, basically mostly for myself and the rest of the researchers in the audience, that although the piano model seems to be out of the picture, there is still a lot that we can learn from those models. And we should also remember that the new models that we introduce are going to fade out one day and are not going to be completely accurate. Although this is very frustrating for some of us, this is the glory of science, and this is how science moves forward. I hope that I was able to show how complex our nervous system is and why it's has been hard to treat such a basic sensation like pain. But most importantly, I hope that I was able to share with you, with all of us that have not experienced chronic pain, a way of imagining and appreciating what people who are suffering from chronic pain deal with when they have out-of-tune sensations. And to tell you how important it is for all of us to focus on improving the quality of life of the patients suffering from different chronic pains like fibromyalgia, neuralgia, chronic pruritus, and all other sensory diseases. Thank you very much.